It's beer o'clock on Real Ale Craft Beer. Today we've got a beer from Browar S, and it's a bottle of their Boris I Imperial, or Russian Imperial Stout, coming in at 9.5% ABV. 330ml bottle, black bottle cap. Looks fantastic. Let's get the beer out into a glass, see what you get. My apologies for the noise. It's November the 5th here in the UK, aka bonfire night. Everybody's outside chucking loads of money into the sky. I'm using Tomek Kapira's beautiful glass. I want to show him off a little bit. Looks, I just had a little whiff of it as well. Looks good, smells good. Yeah, this looks terrific. Thank you very much to Mark Watney in Poland for sending me such a wonderful beer. It is Polish craft beer, I should mention that as well. Browar S, I've never had one of their beers before, but that looks amazing. I'll be able to, if I have a sip, get the aroma first, but once I drink down a little bit, I'll be able to wash the beer around, show you what it looks like. Let's get the aroma. Or jet black beer in the glass, no light bleeding through there whatsoever. Oh, just, there's a little bit of mintiness to it. And then the grains are just coming and coming and coming. It might be a barrel-aged beer. There's a hint of like a woodiness, a whiskiness to it. Maybe a bourbon or something like that. Chocolate, coffee, caramel. Maybe a touch of Bisto gravy, beef gravy, in the best possible light. Licorice, vanilla, cinnamon, maybe some coconut. Oh, it smells amazing. Let's dive in. Cheers, everybody. Stone the Crows, what a terrific example of a Russian Imperial Stout. First thing I got, as soon as the beer hit the inside of the mouth, was a little fizz, a little kind of carbonation, kind of like fizzing away in the inside of the mouth. And then I'm just hit with this wall of flavour, this chocolate, this coffee, this caramel, this vanilla, this cinnamon, this plum, this prune, this figs, this raisins. And then what happens is that the wrapping kind of mouthfeel, the engine oil mouthfeel of this beer, it just dumps itself on your palate and it just sticks there. And the flavours that are involved with that, the beer just gets sent around the inside of the mouth, it sticks on the inside of the mouth, you're getting more of the flavour from the beer. Terrific, terrific example of a Russian Imperial Stout. Prost. Nastavia. I think I got that right as well. If I got it wrong, my apologies. It's terrific. The vanilla, the breadiness, Maybe some of the rye. There might be some rye in there as well. There's a certain, I'm pretty sure, I'll have a look in a moment. I've got some paperwork to talk about the beer. I'm pretty sure it's a barrel-aged beer. I'm pretty sure I'm getting a woodiness, and I'm pretty sure I'm getting like a whiskey wrap on the inside of the mouth. It's really good. Really good stuff. I just want to just stand here and drink it. It's just one of those beers, just, it never stops giving. It just keeps, it's like Christmas, this beer. It just keeps giving. Right, I promised you a little, as I drunk the beer, a little wash round inside of the, it's not doing it so much now. Perhaps my acidic saliva has knocked out the head. But I'm telling you, let's try that way. There's definite carbonation in there. You can see the carbonation, there you go. It's lovely, lovely example. The chocolate, the coffee, and the car, I've not mentioned that really too much yet. If you imagine thick engine oil when it comes to stouts and porters and the way, I'm sure none of you, like me, have ever tried drinking engine oil. But if I tried, I would imagine it just sticking to the inside of my mouth, a bit like this beer. And then with the mouth being, mouthfeel being so thick, so gloopy and so thick and sticky. You think of chocolate, if you were to melt chocolate in your hand or the inside of your mouth, it's sticky. Coffee, big latte, it's sticky, sticks there. Same as caramel, sticky caramel, sticks there. It gives off lots of flavours, loads more flavour. These flavours from the roasted malt or why I think, personally, a stout should be big and fat and bold, like this is in the mouthfeel. Because it portrays what them flavours are supposed to kind of be in their own right, your coffees and your chocolates and your caramels. Before I rate the beer, I want to have a quick read. Russian Imperial Stout, oatmeal. So the oatmeal's give it that kind of big wrap, that big, thick, massive wrap. So the label text, before he appears on the stage, the smells of coffee, dark chocolate, roasted malt spread out. You are intoxicated with the aroma and he enters hurriedly. Boris I, dignified, smooth, dressed in velvet, sweetness fills the room. Don't be fooled, under his smoothness, lies a strong and bitter character, Boris I, from Russia, with love. Well then, that brewery, Shubozhwin, it's made a really incredible beer. I'm going to rate it. Nastravia, there we are, I got it right. For me, that's one of the best Imperial Stouts I've ever had from Poland. It's a 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10 from Real Ale Craft Beer. Please put your comments in the comments box. Subscribe to our daily beer and food reviews. Give us a big fat thumbs up. Boom! Cheers.